Hey everyone, are you struggling to set up your Pi network node because of GCNAT restrictions? Don't worry, I have got you covered. In this video, I'm going to show you a step-by-step guide to set up your Pi network node using a VPS. Say goodbye to connection issues and hello to seamless Pi mining. Let's dive right in. And hey, don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe for more crypto tips. First, let's quickly understand why a VPS is the perfect solution for those dealing with a GCNAT. A VPS, or virtual private server, offers a dedicated IP address, giving your Pi node the stable and direct internet connection it needs to function properly. It's secure, efficient, and works like a charm. Plus, you can set it up from anywhere. Next, you will need a VPS provider. Some popular options include DigitalOcean, Linode, and Volter. For this demo, I will be using Ionis VPS. Choose a plan that meets the requirements of the Pi node. Don't worry, you won't need an expensive one. Usually, the smallest tier works just fine. Once you have signed up and logged in, create your VPS instance. Make sure to select an operating system like Ubuntu 20.04 as it's compatible with the Pi network nodes. Support the channel by signing up for an Ionis VPS using the link in the description. It won't cost you extra, but it helps me create more valuable content for you. Scroll down a little bit and you will find the VPS section. Click on it. Now, click on See Plans. These are all the plans which are provided by Ionis VPS. You will need the minimum one, which will only cost you about $2 per month, which is very enough for Pi network node to run. Make sure to select the data center closest to your country for the best performance. That's only if your country is not mentioned here. After choosing the right data center for you and choosing the preferred Linux VPS for you, click on Configure. When you get to this page, you will notice the system version. Click on it and choose Debian 12 latest. Then click on Next. Now click on Continue and fill your normal billing information and buy your VPS now. After buying your Ionis server, you will get an email from Ionis saying your Ionis server is ready. Click on Cloud Panel to log into your account. Once you log into your VPS account, navigate to the network section, then click on Firewall Policies. Here we will need to add the required ports to ensure your Pi node runs smoothly. Scroll down a little bit and click on My Firewall Policy. Here you will find all the policies which you have added. To add the required policies, come to this section and type in 31400/31409. For the first step, let's keep it TCP and write a distinctive name which you will remember. Write Pi node, for example. Here it says the rules are overlapping. That's because I already have the rules applied, But in your case, you will have a green tick here. Click on it and it will take some time to save. After saving it, do the same thing. Just change it from TCP to UDP. The same numbers, 31400/31409, the same name, no problem, and click on save again. One last rule to add is, where is it? Yes, 51820. Add it here, 51820. Do it both for UDB, click on save, and again do the same port number for TCP. And that will be done for the ports configuration on our VPS. Our next step is to download Termias for connecting our VPS to it. Don't worry, you can download Termias in various operating systems including macOS, Windows and Linux. After downloading Termias and opening it, you go to the right panel and scroll down a little bit. You will find the SSH part. Here you will be required to enter two credentials, which is the username and the password. In the username, write root. Now I will show you from where you will get your password. Now return into your IONOS cloud panel. Make sure you are under infrastructure section on servers. Scroll down a little bit and click on my VPS. After clicking on it, you will find initial password. Click on view password and copy it. After copying it, go back to Termias and type your password in here. After typing in your username and password, you will get this page. Immediately write nano wire guard hyphen setup.sh. Click on enter. You will get this blank page. Now, I will provide a link in the description, a paste bin link, where you will find the essential code. Here is the link. Just scroll down all the way down until you find raw paste data. Copy it and get back into Termias. An important notice. I have a problem with my YouTube channel. Every link I put in the description, it's not clickable. But you could just copy and paste the link, copy the link and paste it on Google Chrome or any browser. Now, after copying the code to paste it, normal Control V won't work. To paste it, click on Control Shift V. Like this. You have pasted the script. Yes, sorry, you have pasted the script. By the way, shout out to my friend T-Shooter for helping me prepare this code. Now, click on Control O to save it. When you get this green highlighted line, click on Enter. Then click on Control X to get out. You will get back to the previous page. Now, write the next code of line, which is chmod plus x wireguard hyphen setup dot sh. Click on enter and now type in sudo dot forward slash wire guard hyphen setup.sh. When you click enter, It will process the data which you have provided. Let's click on Enter. Now it's processing the data which we have provided. For now, it says enter the server's public IP. Which IP is it? It's your VPS IP which you have already bought from your VPS provider. You know, for example, from our IONOS server. I will show you how to get your VPS IP. To get your VPS IP, log in back to your VPS cloud panel. In my case, I have logged in back to IONOS cloud panel. To find your VPS IP, make sure you are on infrastructure section, exactly at servers tab. Scroll down a little bit and here you'll find my VPS alongside with it your IP, which is this one. Double click on it and click on copy. After getting your VPS IP, come back to Termius and click on Ctrl+Shift+V to paste your IP address. Click on enter and it will keep on loading. So like that, we are done with Termius, with this page exactly. Now go back to go to SFTP on the upper part, click on it, connect. Let me show you. Connect to your host, double click on it, wait for it to load. Now search for the client -wg0conf file. Keep an eye on it on this side. On this panel, search for a folder which is easy to access. We want to paste the client into our computer. So for example, I will use my folder called anime. I will draw, let's use another folder. I will use Bangkok, this folder. I will drag and drop my file into here. So you could, as you can see, it's here. The client -wg0.conf. After moving the required file into a well-known folder to you, run Wiresock UI. Get down here into the settings and make sure you tick these required boxes and the log level must be info. Click on save. Then click on add tunnel. Search for the folder where you have moved the file. In my example, I have moved it into the file into the folder named Bangkok. Find the file which you have moved and double click on it. Before activating it, click on edit. And here I will show you some important code to write. As I have said, I will show you some important lines to paste. So Ctrl V, and here we have something called allowed apps. So what's the use of allowed apps? It will restrict the Wiresock VPN only to work to Docker and your Pi app. Also PyCheck if you have downloaded it, and a browser of your choice. So in my example, I have made it into Brave. But if you are not using Brave browser, for example, you are using Chrome, just remove Brave and write Chrome. The use, why is allowed apps important? It's important so it's split tunnels the VPN, so it won't be all over your machine, only for the apps which you have allowed. Now click on save and click on activate. Now let's check if it's running, if it's if the ports are running. Let's go back to Chrome. Let's write in Pi mods, for example. Let's scroll down a little bit. Node open ports checker. As you can see, here is my VPS IP, and let's click on scan. Voila, and now our ports are open. And there you have it, a fully functional Pi network node running on a VPS, bypassing a GCNAT restrictions. I hope this video helped you get your node up and running smoothly. If it did, don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and drop a comment below if you have any questions. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.